there is a measure. And there is always a measure. For example, I want to visit a country. When I used to move freely. I can't move freely today. It's difficult, you know. That kind of tourism I loved, walking on the streets of a city, can't do that anymore, at least not while I am in this office. But the tourism I used to do, I would look up hotels and I would look up places to visit on the net, and I would look at comments of the people on the net to find out what is good, what should I do. For example, it is always an experience. You go to a city and you find, and that happened to me so many times, that you want to go to some place and you take a taxi and you either negotiate the price or whatever, and you leave it to the meter. You don't go from here to here, you go from here to here. It happens all the time. It happens to me in the best of cities of the world, you know. And there was one incident in Chittagong, when we reached there at night and we was going to the hotel, me and my family doing tourism, and there was an argument. I couldn't understand a word, and there were so many taxiwalas and rickshawalas there, and we came to an agreement of about maybe 700 taka for two taxis. And we came out of the railway station, and the hotel we were going through was right next to the railway station, you know. So he just went around and dropped us back here. So these experiences I am sure all of you have had. So therefore, those who have not visited Pakistan, they can look up how much Pakistan is changing. Pakistan is a beautiful country. You are here in Lahore, but I would urge you to, if you have the time or next time you plan, you go to the northern areas where yet climate change has started to affect, but it is not yet so. We have 8 peaks higher than 8,000 meters. We have glaciers. We have beautiful rivers. We have virgin greenery and beauty in the northern areas, still untouched. So this is the time, this is the window of opportunity for business and for enriching yourselves from inside. All these beautiful sights we talk about is not business. It's really internal enrichment when you see the beauty of nature. And humankind has always enjoyed the beauty. Even if you go to a hotel, you look for that kind of room which has a window on a from high up, which looks down on the beautiful places in the city itself. So therefore, Pakistan is today very enriched, open for you and opening up. So when I was talking about those who have not come and those who have come, there's a very significant jump. You talked about the change, Mr. Wilson, you talked about the change, Mr. Becker, you talked about the change. But it is very impressive that a country jumps 28 places in a year in ease of doing business. This is remarkable. That is not only a change, but this is a commitment of the government and the people of Pakistan to ensure that change. That is where I think it is important that you look at these things which are happening, and that is again a major window of opportunity. We are talking about the ease of doing business, and at the same time in the apparel industry and the textile industry, we are looking at good practices. And the manufacturers of apparel in Pakistan are rising to the expectations of their own. The world comes afterwards, because good practices are necessary for us. We tailor things for ourselves first. And the world should be watching the fact that there are good practices in our apparel industry, and in all industries we are trying to ensure that. Today, what is happening in the world? The world is, the rich are getting richer and the poor poorer. That is not your concern today, but that is my concern in Pakistan. And the responsibility of big business are therefore beyond simple profit. It's not only big businesses. Until 10 years ago, were just looking at profits for their stockholders. It is beyond that. It is the responsibility of big business to their own employees, responsibility of big business to their clients, responsibility of big business to the environment, and responsibility of big business to the next generation, which is important. Therefore, the businesses here in Pakistan, I am talking to them, it is very important that you live up to those responsibilities, you gear up to those responsibilities, you look hard within yourself and ensure the fact that Pakistan should not have either child labor, or Pakistan should be thinking in the welfare on your CSR projects, giving back into society what you are making. Otherwise, there is pressure from outside then. The pressure from outside, if you look at international politics today, or for example, the platform of Elizabeth Warren, or the platform of so many other world leaders today, are different. So, meanwhile, to avoid governments looking into that, I think it is a volunteer effort which is the best effort to start looking at that. And therefore, I am concerned, I have been concerned about the fact in Pakistan, let me talk to my Pakistani friends and Pakistani businesses. Employment of women is important, and in the garments and apparel industry, I am sure there is a major employment of women, sometimes more than men. So I think that is a matter of credit. Beyond that, look at employment of disabled people. The disabled are about 10 to 12% of every society. You may not be concerned today, because today there are suppliers and there are manufacturers and there are hopeful joint ventures, but I may not get the opportunity to talk to my own people in business for this particular situation. And employment for disabled is not the fact that disabled can be given simple jobs, but the fact that jobs are tailored to the disabled people. That's a huge difference between just providing jobs and then getting dissatisfied with the fact that we did employ disabled people and they were not able to give us service. So this is a partnership which works with two hands. There is training which needs to be given to the disabled, and there is training which needs to be given to the people who employ them. Pakistan is very happy. Things are changing. Now, what used to happen is that the manufacturers or the producers of apparel would give it to the suppliers, the wholesalers in the Western world, who would then give it to the retailers, and from the retailers it would go to the consumer itself. So there were 3 or 4 steps, but the world is changing. The number of steps are reducing. And that is where the market is opening up for everybody. For Pakistan businessmen, the market is opening. You have to be smart to jump into. So it's not business to business. Of course it is business to business, but it is becoming from business to the wholesaler, from business or manufacturer directly to the buyer or directly to the consumer. The market is spreading in so many ways. And therefore, the smartness of countries like us is important. We should be looking at markets in a different way compared. There is a generational change. There is a fourth industrial revolution which will force us to look at things in a very different manner. And countries which can understand that change which is happening, adapt to it and modify and give opportunities to the youth to start looking at that, will be more successful, will have faster jumps than anything else. I've seen even in Pakistan and elsewhere that the link between, a direct link to the needs of the consumer, people have set up enterprises which within a few years are worth tens of billions of dollars. And that is where our youth need to be trained, our youth need to be given an entrepreneurial push, our youth need to be given opportunities to jump into that market. So ladies and gentlemen, there is a lot which Pakistan is doing. It is a very hopeful, like you mentioned, Mr. Wilson, it is the new Pakistan. It is a Pakistan which all of a sudden people are finding out this is a land of opportunity. It's a land of the fifth or the sixth largest population in the world, And I believe as we change, and we are changing very fast, as we change, Pakistan was at the tipping point. Now Pakistan has tipped towards tremendous change. And those of you who can get on it now, even our own people, I am talking to local businesses, I am talking to you also, those who can understand that the opportunities are multiplying, there's a paradigm shift. It is not going from 2 to plus 2 to 4, it is going from 2 to a multiple of 4 to 8 to 16 and 32. In that respect, Pakistan is changing. So welcome to Lahore, enjoy Pakistan, and whatever we can do for you in ease of doing business, my office is there to the leaders sitting here, my office is there, and we can together make a big change in this industry also, and wish you good luck. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.